Hi folks, I thought we'd try a little Bohemian Rhapsody tonight. So I'm going to just mention a couple of things, okay? Good evening. Hi folks. I thought I would come back and play another round. The news today is really enlightening. So instead of a few weeks where we batten down the hatches, or even a few months, they're now saying, well, it's probably towards the end of the year before we can actually come out of our bunkers. So it's not entirely unexpected, is it? And it feels pretty hard to compute, I would say. It's like the loss of your freedom for a very long time. But looking at it in context, I guess my grandfather was called up to the First World War, which was 1914 to 1918. And went to slog away in the trenches and breathe gas, poison gas. So perhaps what we're being asked to do isn't that. We just have to deal with it, and I'm sure we can find ways of dealing with it. And music is part of it, so I'm going to play you a song. I'm not going to play you a song, I'm going to play you a solo, because you gave me great feedback. Thank you so much yesterday for the little question that I put to you, like, what would you like me to play? And huge variety, which maybe I can work my way through. I don't think it's a good idea for me to pitch into Pink Floyd or Zeppelin or whatever, you know, because I will only be able to do my versions, which is kind of, it's fun, but I don't think it's very, I don't think it's pushing forward the frontiers. But a lot of people said, show us how you play your solos like I did in Starlix many, many years ago. And the one that probably was asked most of all was the one that goes in the middle of that very complex tune written by Freddie called Bohemian Rhapsody. So I thought I'd show you that. I can show you it normal. There we go, something like this. Now you could come in closer and see the fingers. I don't do anything difficult. I'm not the world's greatest expert technical guitar player. I just play how I feel and try to use the guitar as a voice. So come a little closer, okay? And I'll show you that again. So I hope you can see the fingers. I'm gonna move this hand up a bit so that you can see it. I wouldn't normally be playing it. Plucking it right there, I'd be back here, but maybe you can see when I'm plucking it and when I'm not. You'll notice that I don't hit every note with this hand at all. There's a lot of snapping ons, like, and snapping off, like, where only the first note is hit. And there's a few little twiddles, as you can see, and there's a few bends. Some of the bends start here and get squeezed upwards, and some of them start up and get squeezed down, and maybe both. So I'll show you roughly what this it's actually I don't hit any of those except the last note. I'm snapping off and on again. Yeah, there's no plucking at all going on there. So I hope that's a little bit clearer. If you want to talk about it, send me some notes if you like. But I hope that's I hope that's helpful. That's dealt with that then. Have a very good night and wake up feeling a little hopeful, okay? God bless. Some of you guys have asked me what kind of gear I'm using for these little micro concerts. Well, the answer is not very much, because I can't get into my studio at the moment. I'm taking the self-isolation thing very seriously, as I think you have to. I think everybody has to cut down their social interactions as much as they can in order for us to stand a chance of keeping this virus in check. So for me, as much as I can is the whole way. I'm not interacting with anybody except me missus. And that means I can't at the moment get to the studio. I can see that possibly changing as time goes on if there is an emergency or some other thing happens. But for the meantime, that's what it is. So here's what I got here. First of all, a little tripod with a holder for the iPhone, which is very useful. You can angle it where you want. And then here's the guitar. This is straight off the production line of Brian May Guitars, and I signed it and then realized that I really like this one. I sign about 40 of these every week. And this one has a particularly beautiful grain, so I thought I'd like to keep this one for a while at least and play with it. And it gives me a chance to assess how well they are coming off the production line. And the answer is really good at the moment. This one's absolutely perfect so far. Keeps its tune, keeps its intonation, and sounds like a cracker. So that's the guitar. This is a wire, and this is the amp. This is a very tiny Vox amp. I really like this thing. They call it a Mini 5 Rhythm. And it's very small, but does lots of stuff. It's got a lovely selector here, which sort of tunes you from the 1970s to the present day. I'm actually on California metal at the moment, which means that Queen must have been well ahead of their time, I guess, because we were driving the amps hard. Over here, you have a fine control on how far into distortion you're driving it. You have a tone control, and this is the output level, the volume. Down here, there's a couple of very nice little effects arrangements, and you can see I've got a piece of chorus on here, and I've got a bit of echo on here. There's actually a multiple repeat echo, which I really enjoy. We call it splinge where I come from. This bit over here I don't use at the moment. It's a rhythm box, so you can give yourself some kind of imitation drums to play with if you want. But that's my gear, that's my setup, and suits me fine. Well, I think if you got this far, you must be an addict or a geek like me. So thank you for listening and watching if you have. The only thing I should probably add is that I didn't use a pick for this. Normally I would use a sixpence, and I did on the original recording of Bohemian Rhapsody, of course. But I use the fingernail now a lot more, and tonight it just seemed appropriate. It gives me a lot of control on the sound and the feel. These days I use the fingers a lot more on stage. That's about it, really. I hope it was a good evening for you, and let's talk soon, huh?